La histoire des Schtroumpfs. Hmm. Payo. Oh.
That's us.
Yes, this is the one.
We sat down with Veronique Culliford, the daughter of Pierre Culliford, better known as Payo. Producer Jordan Kerner and director Raja Gosnell of the upcoming Sony Pictures and Sony Pictures Animation release, The Smurfs, to talk about Global Smurfs Day and the history of the Smurfs.
It says here Smurfs are mythical creatures from Belgium, also known as Strumpfs, documented by Payo.
Veronique, mm-hmm. What was Payo like as a person?
He's a very kind man and a very good father and also a very good friend. Everybody likes him.
Your father had a love of the Middle Ages.
He loves the stories of Robin Hood and the stories of Snow White. He was projectionist in the cinema and he saw the movie so many times.
While busy working on his popular comic strip, Johan and Pee-wee, Payo created the enchanted characters as part of a new storyline. But what to call them?
And he said, what name they can have? And then he remembered that he had a conversation with a friend during a lunch. He would like just to have the salt on the table. And he don't remember the name, the salt. He said, give me the Smurf. Strumpf in French.
Okay, to review. You guys come from a magic forest where you live in oversized mushrooms.
Yes.
You're being chased by an evil wizard.
Yeah.
And you like to use the extremely imprecise term Smurf for just about everything.
Smurf, exactly.
A lot of people ask me why are the Smurfs blue, and I'd say because they're Smurfs. But was there a reason behind the color?
My father said they cannot be human, they cannot be green because they are not coming from Mars or another place. And he had a problem and asked my mother. And my mother chose the blue because we have to see them directly, and in the green of the forest and the brown of the forest, it's the best color.
They became so popular, Payo decided they deserved their own comic to the delight of their fans.
You're all named after your personalities? Do you get your names when you're born or after you've exhibited certain traits?
Yeah.
Yep.
I remember hearing stories about how your father would find inspiration for some of the Smurf characters in the home and in the neighborhood, you know, like specifically Smurfette.
People said that he take my hair like an example. Then he take the drawings and he took pictures and then he made a Smurfette like that.
Modeled after
you. Oh, yes.
Smurfalish!
Soon, Smurf mania took over the world. The Smurfs were everywhere, including a hugely successful television series.
When I first was introduced to the Smurfs around 1980 and I saw them, I realized these are incredibly unique little characters.
Now, 30 years later, the beloved mythical creatures are hitting the big screen.
Oh my Smurf.
We wanted to make it very different than the cartoon. We wanted to put the Smurfs in a live action world.
We never think about the live action. And in fact, we saw the first stage of that animation. And they said, maybe it's not a bad idea.
But bringing the Smurfs into the real world would take some special magic.
We started with Payo's drawings. So we worked with different skin textures, peach fuzz hair on the top, all those little life cues.
How could anybody think that?
Whoops. You're just surprised. They are very different. They have so many humanity in them.
I think the nuanced performances that they have, these little creatures that Payo created and then we've brought to life through current day technologies, are one of our proudest achievements.
I'm so proud of you, Clumsy.
I think it's really important that film, which often confronts the audience, every once in a while gives a gift to the audience, but can also help them to look at the world in a different way, maybe a smurfier way.
Yes, absolutely.
Bring it in, big fella.
We wanted to honor your father and you and everyone who have kept the spirit going.
And I'm sure the spirit of my father is in the movie. All the things that my father liked to see in his character or in his stories, everything is there. And we are lucky.
Fantastic.
It's fantastic.
There's no doubt these adorable, lovable, and smurftacular little heroes are going big places.
No Smurf left behind.
And now you can be a part of Smurf history on Payo's birthday, June 25th.
In 2009, 2,500 people dressed up as Smurfs set the world record. This time it's going to be all over the world. The last time was only one country, I believe, each time. So worldwide here.
Anyone dressed like a Smurf?
Yes, everybody has to have white pants, white shoes, white hat, and a blue t-shirt.
Do you have to paint your face blue?
Absolutely, in blue too.
Okay.
Blend in.
I think we're gonna smash the record.
You think so?
So we're going for a smash.
Yes.
Hi everyone, I'm Katy Perry, here to remind you all to get out for the Global Smurfs Day on June 25th. And don't forget to see the Smurfs this summer.
Check out globalsmurfsday.com for more info.